up in rural Maine, and as an athlete, I had aspirations of wanting to go off to college and continuing my career. And initially, no one in my family had gone off to college, so that in itself was going to be different. And thankfully, I had a bunch of people supporting me along the way, my family, teachers and coaches. And luckily enough, I ended up in the Boston area. And that opportunity was pretty amazing, to be a collegiate athlete and getting a great education and at the same time competing at a high level. That was wonderful. And right out of college, I jumped right into the teaching profession. I was very lucky to get a job at a local school in the greater Boston area. And from there, my path continued onward and upward. I found Newton South High School. I had a situation where I was actually training a 65-year-old shot putter at a local track, and I ran into a former coach that I knew for a long time, and he mentioned that there was a wellness position open at Newton South High School, and I decided that I would take this position and learn as much as I could about wellness and how that was working in kind of relatively new back in the 1998 when we were teaching. I think only five high schools teaching wellness in the area. So fast forward, I ended up seeing the position open for MIT, and Jordan Roldan and I both kind of looked at each other and said, that would be right where we'd want to be in regards to a place where we'd want to go with competitiveness, excellence in wellness. So we decided to take a chance, and here it is 5 years later. It's been a wonderful opportunity to work with the staff at MIT and to work with the student athletes, and knowing that wellness is at the forefront of what they appreciate and value, along with excellence. So that's really was a good fit for me, and the timing was perfect. I love coaching at MIT because of the camaraderie and the culture that it has grown over the years. I coached against MIT about 25 years ago, and certainly they had very competitive programs and the students were awesome and amazing, but I didn't really understand what MIT was about until I kind of stepped on campus and started to engage with the staff, the Daber staff, and getting to know some of the people and how they kind of take care of the students at MIT. I love that the fact that the students' well-being is put at the forefront of their experience. They're there to get an excellent education, but bottom line, we're creating a culture that is driven by excellence, and the student is at the forefront of that drive, and their well-being is really important. So that kind of resonated with me, and I love working there. It's just amazing to the people you deal with, and the expectations are amazing. A lot of wonderful memories that I have in the four short years that I've coached. I would have to say, last year we took a trip to Poughkeepsie, New York, to play Vassar. It was a Friday night fight. And they were, I think, ranked top 10 at the time, if I remember correctly. And the student body just came out in droves, and they were wild and crazy. So you had a hostile environment. Their team was obviously very good. We were a young team. We had a lot of freshmen and sophomores playing important roles for us early on. And we had a five-set match. The guys were amazing. Our team focused on each other and didn't get distracted by the fans, didn't get distracted by the refs or the other team. And it was an amazing night. And I guess you could call it an upset. I mean, we always believe in ourselves, but on that given night, it was special. We enjoyed it. First thing you're going to notice when you come in the gym for practice is the whiteboards. I try to be meticulous about what we're working on and why we're working on it. It's organized you know, to every little detail. It's got statistics and numbers going on throughout the entire practice. Like to have a lot of data to drive our decisions when deciding who's going to do what for us on the court. And we also want to, you know, see how people improve through the course of the season. So if we can kind of be meticulous about our practices, we'll definitely improve, but we'll also know who to use and when to use them. So it's a pretty involved endeavor, and one I enjoy. I love planning practice, and I love trying to get the most out of it. And thankfully, you know, the student athletes that we have at MIT, they like to run with it. So they're, you know, taking a peek at that board, absorbing it, and they're already off and running. So it saves us so much time. And we get a lot of quality in a very short practice compared to, you know, some other teams I've coached over the years. So it's been extremely enjoyable. I love competing in the UVC. This conference has been one of the top conferences in the country for a while. And the fact that over half of our teams get ranked in the top 15 through the course of a season is a lot of pride there. And knowing that you've got to fight every night when you're playing a UVC team, whether it be traveling to New York, going to Elmira, or up to Rochester, those are some pretty long road trips. But, you know, they have to do the same thing when they come to MIT. But knowing that, you know, chances are you're playing someone or you have the potential to be in the top four in the country is always an amazing feeling. And I enjoy the fight. The guys love it. And we're trending well. We're going to be making some noise of our own over the next year or two. So we're looking forward to those New York battles. So we love our UVC brothers. Probably the thing that I really love about recruiting at MIT is that although I know I can only get a small number of guys, you know, into MIT and playing volleyball for us, the fact that I get to engage and get to know hundreds of student athletes who have this passion to play, you know, helping them, you know, whether it be MIT or whether it be another school, helping them find a place to go and continue their careers as volleyball players is really fun. I think it's so exciting. I think we have over 112 Division III programs. You know, and if you go back to 7 or 8 years ago, we were lucky if we had, you know, 30 or 40, and we were hoping to, you know, have a national championship. And now we've been the fastest growing sport in the country. And it's been amazing. So it's great to help the sport grow and people, and help the, you know, the student athletes find places to play. Well, there's the obvious, you know, academic accolades, certainly, you know, great volleyball skills, but I would say for me, the most important thing that I want to find in a recruit is great character. Someone who values the relationships that they form through activities. You know, we're all excited about wanting to win and be competitive and, you know, do these amazing things. But in the end, when the dust settles, you graduate, and, you know, volleyball comes to an end at the collegiate level. It's your relationships that are going to withstand time, not necessarily whether you won or lost, although we do want to win. But it goes back to that character. If you can find athletes with great character who are trust willing, who are empathetic, just people that love the relationships that they form, that is going to be the catalyst for greatness for our program. And last year's team, although it was kind of young, it was amazing to see how well they came together and how there had been a little bit of a culture shift with the way that they went about playing volleyball. And an example of that would be, you know, a guy who's on the bench or a guy who's just subbed out who's going to the bench. The fact that you turn around, you look down the bench, and there he is putting all of his energy and focus on the guys that are on the court. He's not dwelling on his mistakes. He's not dwelling on the fact that he's not in the game. He's dwelling on the fact that we're a team and a family trying to be the best we can be. And that makes it really, really enjoyable. And the new recruits always bring a new vibe for us. So really exciting. And this 2021 class is going to bring another level of character for us as well.